What's up to all my freelancers and creatives out there? Have you been working in your freelance creative business and then you get a request, but this time the request comes from your friend or family member? That's what we're gonna get into in this episode of Freelance Jumpstart TV. Oftentimes it's unavoidable. You know, you're working in your business, things are going well, and you get a request, but this time the request from work comes from a friend or family member. More than likely, maybe they saw your journey along the way, and honestly, maybe they really do respect your skills. However, the question remains, are they gonna respect your process, and are they gonna respect your price? It can be very difficult working with friends and family because there's a couple of things at stake. You wanna work with them and you wanna help them, however, you don't wanna risk the friendship and relationship you have, because if things go bad, then there's this awkwardness to the relationship. Not only that, but things can go very well. However, maybe because they're your friend or family member, they want the family hookup or they want the friendship discount. And really, nothing changes as your business. You're still providing value, you're still doing work, you're still investing time. So why discount? I've spoken to many other freelancers about this and everybody has a different opinion. Some people say no, some people say just flat out do it. Some people just say, you know what, I try to keep my business a secret from my friends and family. So you never really know what the true answer is. But here are some tips you can use to guide your decision on whether or not you should work with your friends and your family in your business. I listen to a podcast pretty much every week, and the podcast is by Sean McCabe and Ben Tolson, and they have the Sean West podcast. They have a phrase on there which they say, and the phrase is full price or free. I agree with their thinking and I align and relate to that phrase. If you're gonna work and offer your services, it needs to be one of two things. It needs to be the full price or it needs to be free. And this also applies in the case of working with friends and family. You know, if you really think about it, your friends and family should be the main people supporting you in your business, right? So it makes sense that they should pay the full price because they want to support you. And the best way to do that is to pay the full fee. You have to also look at it from their perspective. For example, family members. They've been with you this whole time, you know, if your dad or your mother ask you to do something, they're thinking about all the things that they've done for you in your entire life. So for you to just, you know, give them a free discount, you know, it should be nothing to you. I mean, you know, they raised you, they fed you, you know, they changed your diapers, you know, just do the work. That's their perspective. But in reality, there are costs to serving friends and family for free, because if you do, that's taken away from time in which you could have done something. So again, on one end, you know, charge the full price, treat them just like a regular customer, and even tell them that. Just say, you know, mom, dad, brother, sister, you know, your friend, just let them know, hey, I'm just gonna let you know, I do respect you as a friend, but as it comes to business, I'm gonna treat you like I treat all of my clients. In fact, I'm gonna make sure that you get superb customer service, but I'm gonna make sure you follow my process, and this is what my process is. If they can agree to that, great, you know, work with them. Now, on the other side of full price or free, if you do choose to work with them and you're not charging anything, it still remains the same way. Treat them like an actual client. Still take them through the process and make sure you get something out of the transaction. So work for free, you know, just do it, it's okay. But if you do, make sure they get the full process, or you set expectations up front. You say, I will be working with you. I am gonna do it. There's gonna be no cost, of course. However, this is how it needs to go. If you don't set clear expectations, then you may get endless requests from your friends and family who may see you on a weekly basis, and then it never really stops, and you never really get a chance to transition to paid work. So if you do offer to work for free for friends and family, make sure you set expectations and tell them how it goes. One more thing you need to do when working for free is, and I've said this in prior episodes, but I want to say it again. One thing that you need to do is give them a proper invoice. However, show them what the amount is, show them what the price is, but show them also it's been zeroed out and they don't have to pay anything, but show them the work I'm providing for you. It really is $3,000. It really is $5,000. However, I'm not charging you that, but this is what the price actually is. At the least, they can see the invoice and comprehend they really are getting the value, and that can just help them appreciate you more, that you're investing in their relationship, in the friendship, you know, in your family members. Another tool you can use to guide your decision in working with friends and family: are you really interested in the work they're bringing to the table? I'll be honest, I've worked with my family and they've brought things to me and asked for help, and I really had no level of interest in that particular thing. And it really was very agonizing and grueling just to get through the process, because I wasn't excited about the work. It was just something I was doing because I felt obligated. You know, so really ask yourself the question: are you interested in the work by any means? And even if you're not interested in the work, are you interested in the end result of what they're producing? Try to find something to be interested in so you can use that as motivation. Not sure about you, but for me, if I don't have any little bit of motivation, even if it's, you know, growing my friendship and furthering the relationship, then it's very hard for me to work, because I just lose motivation and lose sight on, why am I really doing this? I don't want to do it. Why am I doing it? Following up on that point, it is okay to say no. I do know some other freelancers, when they work with friends and family, they say no to everything. They say, I just don't work with friends and family. I just don't. And that's their standard, and that's what they've said. You can do the same. Or you can take another route. You can say no, but make sure to recommend somebody who does similar work to you, or somebody else that would be good for your friends or your family member's project. So if a family member comes to you, you can say something to the effect of, hey, just to let you know, I value our friendship and I don't want to risk anything or losing that. So, you know, I'm definitely going to recommend you work with this particular person. And if you have any questions for me on a consulting level, I don't mind giving you any bit of advice, but this person would be better to work with you, because I don't want to risk the good friendship we have. So when it comes to the whole working with friends and family, should you give them a discount? I don't like doing that, but in all honesty, it's really not going to hurt anything. If you do provide a discount, like I mentioned earlier, set expectations. But also, you know, invest in your friendship. You know, if you're giving them something of this much value and you treat them like a normal customer, you treat them like a normal client, you send them an invoice, you're very professional, they'll respect that level of professionalism and they may end up being your biggest cheerleader in the process. You know, and just let them know, you know, other people won't get this discount. You're just doing it because of your relationship with them. So if you want to invest in a relationship, there's nothing wrong with that. So really just bringing things all together, nobody is right or wrong in this question of should you work with friends and family. To be honest, there's some things that if my parents asked me, I probably couldn't get out of it if I wanted to, because, you know, they would get mad. So I might as well just do it, and that's okay. And since that's the case, that's something I need to expect. But as I mentioned earlier, there are guidelines that you need to set for your business, and just say, as long as they meet these guidelines, it's all good. Or, hey, based upon where I'm at in my business, I got a lot of work right now. I cannot do that for you. This person may be able to. This person may be able to help you, but I can't help you right now. Just tell them about the guidelines. Mention to them and say, okay, definitely, I have guidelines. If you meet this criteria, we're good. That way, the burden of whether or not they work with you is not really on you and your conscience. It's on their willingness to work with your process. Thank you once again for checking out this video. I greatly appreciate it. If you're watching the video, go ahead and give this a thumbs up. If you're listening on the podcast, leave a review. I read those and make this show better. I want to make sure I'm bringing value to everyone. As always, there are show notes for this particular episode, so you can go to freelancejumpstart.tv/38 and you can see the notes for this particular episode. And I'm curious, you know, I really want to hear from you all. Let me know, what do you do when it comes to friends and family? And do you work with them? Do you have a policy of saying no? What do you do, and how have you handled it in the past? And now, knowing what you know, how are you going to handle it going forward in the future? As always, I will catch you in the next one. See ya.